So, hi everybody and welcome back. This is our Unreal Engine 5 production series for absolute beginners. In this series we create and I demonstrate coding, and not only coding, also level design, try and so, and give many, many informations. And in this video, which is video 6, we continue with our last creation we have created in the last video, this blueprint here, which was our teleport. And in this one I changed this, you can see it a little bit, I stretched it a lot. This one is a cheap trick, I will explain it to you later, but for those guys who don't want to watch the whole video, I show it here at start so you know what we are going to do. So first of all, we stretch this blueprint here, the visual a little bit. Then I create a spawn area, a blueprint spawn area, which is very cheap. Ooh, I just added a collision box and I extended the X and Y value. So we have this area and this collision box I placed, let me open my map, a third person map. And this one you can see I placed just here in the scene. And this one actually we don't need. And our goal is when we start the game, the created teleport should spawn here within this collision box spawn area randomly. And to do it randomly, we have to code, and the code section I did in a third person game mode. I don't know if this is the best solution, perhaps there is another solution much better. I just take the first solution which I found and I made it, and it looks like this. We start with event begin play, then we make a map checker. This is this third tier, it's a branch, we check just which map we are on, and if it's the right map, then it should execute this code, which is, we get all actors of class, because I need this spawn area here, and I don't know how to get it easier, so I use this node, which is in general not a very good node, but yeah. It works. And then if you get this one, you can then with this one we get this spawn area, and with spawn area we have access to all the things what we have here in this class, which and I needed it only because of this collision area which I created. So I get here the details, and then from this one I get here the details, the root component and the called spawn area extended, and then a box extend, get world location. So I needed this information just for this node, and this node is just this random point in boundings box. This is my random creator, and this one is this input here, what you see here from the box area is just the area in which it should create this random point. And then I use just a spawn actor. And that's it. And then of course here you specify the class which you want spawned. In our case, our open new level, which is our teleport. So that was the fast showcase for those guys who don't want show all the full video, and now we make it step by step, create all steps from scratch here what I showed, so that you can follow along, and I explain of course a little bit more than what I said here. So first of all, let's get started. But before we get started, let me bring back this settings here which I have just made for showing. So we are here, the first thing what we need is we go to our created teleport, this one we created in our last, and you see a strange thing here, it is very long, at start it was very short. And what I did is I go here to the collision box which we created, and I went then here to details panel down to box extent, and I have changed the Z value, which you can see it's very high now. So the question is why I did this, right? The problem is here is our map, and I want spawn it here on this map in this box area, which I will show you in a moment, which we can see this. Let me click this. Oh, this is not good. Where is my, why is this so? Anyway, let's see if I can BP spawn area. This is the BP spawn area, and later, let me open this one up. I show you this fast. This one, what we created here, will spawn anywhere here later with our random program, which we are going to write in a moment. But the problem here is we have here objects, right? And at start, this was very small, and this area is here, and it could happen that it spawns in this object. To avoid this, I used a very cheap trick, which you can see here. If this one is spawning, let's say at this position, it will still be accessible for my character here on top, because the box goes here all the way up. That's the reason why I make this. This is a very cheap trick, because if I do not this one, I had to specify also here on top an area, or here on top. And to avoid that, I just made this cheap trick. Just make here it long. It doesn't hurt. It's just there. So you can make it even longer if you have bigger objects here or so. That said, so this is the first thing, what you change, what you can change. We make it just longer. And how we change this, you can write here a number. Of course, you can go here to the viewport, press again our standard translate and scale and rotate. And in this case, of course, it is, careful, not scale. Don't use the scale here, because that's very important. Because this one here on top, that was a little bit wrong, is using the scale. It works too, by the way, it works too. But when we are working here with a collision box, there is a special, a special extent option. You can see it on shape, and then a box extent, and then we are using this one normally. But I'm not sure about this myself, because scale would work too. And you have to figure out and read why you use this one and when you use this one. Just read it on the documentation. But the only thing what we need is it must be big and large enough so that our character can walk into, even when it spawns here. That said, we are finished with that. The next point. Now we have our teleporter, but the next point is we have to create this spawn area, right? This was not there, the spawn area which I have already created. So let's see how we create this. This was not created in our last video. Let's make it fast. We go to blueprints, we go to click right click on it, then we go to our blueprint class, yes, and then we choose again this actor. And then we write our convention BP for blueprint underscore. I already have one. I call this spawn area 2 because I have one. You can call it just spawn area. And you press enter. We open this up. We dock it on the top. And we make faster compile save so we have it. And what we are doing here is just adding a collision box, because this will be, let me show this. This one will be our spawn area later. And we will write a code in this. But it will be spawned here in this area. And I will show you in code how we can do this later. But let's create our blueprint. So we have this one. What we need is we go here to the add. We go to collision box. We write col. And then it jumps here. All our options. We can use a box capsule. And so we choose box. And we name it. Perhaps you name it spawn area. Let's call it this time spawn area. Important is when you write it this way and at start, you perhaps don't know instantly what kind of type it is. This collision box is the type. You can see it when I hover over it. It says there box collision, collision box also. And one way is that you learn this icon here left side, or you can you can do use here also a convention if you want. You can go on top again, write call something like that, and then underscore all spawn area. This will work too. The problem here is later perhaps with finding this underscore. I'm not sure if this is working very well. You can make this. Let's use it. Why not? And we see it. Okay. Then we have our collision array. The next point is. Go compile, we go save, and this collision area we need now find the size. The best way to find the size is just we are going to let's lock this one here to make this. We have now created our blueprint. We have called it I have called it spawn area 2, and to find the size I just drag and drop this blueprint here, and now there are different ways, and now you can go to your spawn and then just test it. You can just write here numbers. In my case, I don't want not to waste time. I just go to my already created spawn area and I know the number. Okay, X is 1300, Y is 1500. That's good. So and I write here 1300 was that, and the other was 1500. And that was total wrong, of course, because I wrote it on the wrong place. Oh, yes. 1500, 1500, and this. So, and then when you compile and save that, so I changed this in my blueprint, but I put it here and you can see I have here, and then you can see and adjust this like you want. So later you can adjust this. Perhaps you don't like this one and change the height perhaps too, and so on. But right now this is fine, and we can delete this one here because we want spawn this one. No, that's not true. Let me show you something. This blueprint, which we just created, the spawn area, we don't want spawn. This one, we want just place it here in our scene because here it should spawn it. And this is all time fixed. It's all time the same place. So that's why we place this created area now here, and you place it where you want spawn your teleport. So this will be the area where you want spawn your teleport. Yeah, so I use now my second one, the spawn area. It's here placed, you can see it, and we continue. The next thing is okay, we have created a spawn area, that's finished. We have created our spawn object, which is our teleport. That's finished, but we miss now something. And what is the thing what we are missing? We need a way to spawn this now here. And this one works with coding. So this is a little bit coding now. And we have to, and we get right to it. But before we get right to it, there is one problem. How we, where we code this? Because this is all time a question which we have ask ourselves at start, because there are many places where we can code actually this thing. We can try to code it here. That would make, don't think so, it's good. we could code here, because this blueprint has all time, you can see, a coding section too. This one has a coding section, but, and there is another way. In my case, I choose not even one of them, I choose the game mode. And very important is we have to find this maps game mode, and this maps game mode, I set it to third person game mode. When you have the world settings, you can just go to the game mode, click here on focus, here it will be jumped there. And I use this third person game mode. So the question is why I'm using this third person game mode, just for a fast explanation. It is our start point. Like I said in the last time, the start point is a very good place to set the basic rules for this map, and after this one all will follow these rules. And this one is a good place to set some basic settings as well, like this one. That's why I choose this. Must be not the best place, can be the best place. You have to watch here a little bit of documentation and search if this is the best place or not, and decide on your own. And I decided here to go with our game mode, and then you go to your game mode, you open up your third person game mode, and we will code this one. But of course, let's don't watch this one here, what we have, because you don't will have this one. I just use it as a reference. So let's start here over step by step. The first thing what you are going to do is, in viewport, in your game mode, you have nothing. You change to the event graph. In event graph, you have not this big in player 2. You click, let's go rid of this one too. So the first thing is you right click here on this place, and then you search event begin play. This node here is a standard node. You will see it almost all time, because this node means when you start here play, this one will trigger. So this one is, and not here only, in general when you start the game, this node will trigger. And I set this file, the game mode, is the first file which is started before all other, but then the character comes, the widgets and so on. This one will start at first. So, and what we need then? Then let's see, let's think about. So we have here our spawn area, we have our here our BP open new level, and we want that this one spawns automatically anyone here in this point. So how we are going to this, I watch what I have here so I don't make too much different things here. I get, okay, this one we'll make later. This one, yes, we make it later too normally. Let's start here at the end, because this one I have to explain a little bit. That's why. The first thing what you want is normally you go and go right away a very common used node, which is spawn actor from class. This node is so often used, you will learn this instantly later because you use it most time. So what is this node actually? This means you are getting an actor and you will spawn it, and this is actually what we want, right? Actors are all for example, this blueprint is also an actor, right? Because here I made this example, I go here, right click blueprint class, and you can see we clicked here actor, blueprint actor, perfect. It is an actor, so we can spawn this. So, and when I go here and find my BP underscore, and you see I have here already so much, and actually I even don't know perhaps the name, that's the worst case, then I will not find it. But I showed you a very easy example. You go to the blueprints if you have not so, and if you know at least here the name, you can go here to the thing what you want. For example, you can read here the name and write there, but the easy way is you just select, go back, and then you have here this back arrow. Just click this. This one is connected here with the selected object, and it takes over, and now I know what to spawn. The next thing is, that is the first thing what this node wants, what I should spawn, it is asking, and I said you should spawn this teleport. All right, I will spawn your teleport, but there is one more very important thing, which is what this node is asking. It says, okay, I will spawn this teleport, but where, right? Because we have here, because he is spawning, and we have here place, and the next question is where, and he is asking for this here on the second point here, what you can see, spawn transform, and here we have to point out our point where we spawn. There are many ways how we can spawn it, because perhaps you don't want to make a random spawn, you want just spawn it in a certain location, and then you can write this certain location directly here in. Here is a trick, I show you the two. You go here on spawn transform, right click it, and then you can split struct, and then we have the transform all different kind of settings here. This is the location, the rotation, and the scale, and you noticed, right? Let me show you something. We go to the viewport, not here, was here's of course nothing. So for example, here the call area, all the basic things which can have a transform, you can see here on top has this one, what which we placed here in the scene, has also this location, rotation, scale, and even the other one, the level one, the call, has also a location, rotation, scale, and that's why this one is very important and easy to get most time, because we just get this location, rotation from the scene, and yeah, that's manually, that's for example, you can write here manually where you want just spawn this one. Let's make here fast an example without a manual spawn. But the problem is here, you have to get this location. It's not a big problem because 0, 0 should be anywhere here. Let's make it as a demonstration. I go to compile, save, and then I start this. Let's see what happens. This one, is it not probably? Or is it? Could be this one. Yes, it is this one. And the problem, the map changed. Where is it? Third person map. Okay, the point is, this one, was it not right? I'm not sure. Let me. And it is spawned. Okay. Let me check if this was wood again. No, it was not this one. So the point is, it's not really spawning here right now, because normally it should spawn on a point where it says 0, 0, 0. And right now this location is not here anyhow. But let me show you. Anyway, let's find a position. I want to show you how you can find also a position, which is the manual way. Yeah, you can, for example, say I want spawn it here. Then you can just grab something, an object, or you can add here. Let me show you this one. You know, where's that place actors? For example, you can just take this actor and place it here. And what you are doing is, and then say I once wanted here or here, then you just have selected this actor, you go to the details panel, and then you just read manually this location. This is also one way to get it, perhaps not the best way, but also not the worst way, you know. For example, you just want to get this location, you make here a just dummy actor which will delete after you get this position. And here it says, for example, 1800. Let's go here and write this around. It was around any 580 or something. 580, and here was 1800. And so, and let's see if this works. Compile, save, and save all here. Oops. Not this one. This one, save all here. Let's start this for a test. And is this here? Yes, you can see it is one. This is the manual way, but this we don't want this manual way. This was just a demonstration. And what we want is this one should spawn here randomly. And now let's go on. Let me see what I did here, because I work from packet 2.4. Okay, what I did here is let me explain you that the problem here is, and we learned this, this is also a new coding thing which you have to learn at start. We need to spawn this here in this area a reference to this where is this? I can't click this all time. This spawn area, right? So we need our so-called reference. And why we need this, let me show you that one. So the spawn area says, let's bring this back to the normal. We can again recombine this pins, and we can split this. This is nice, but we want now get first this spawn area here in our coding. We need this. Why we need this? Because this is the location where I want spawn my teleport. So what I'm doing is then, first of all, what I'm doing there? Yes, there is a problem. That was the problem, and that's why I said perhaps this one is not the best. Oops, of course I have a compiler error, because I need to write here location. Let's go back. Split string, let's keep this one here. The point is, there is a problem, because how I get now this spawn area in my coding. And this is a general problem, not a general problem. It's called we need a reference, and there are easy way to reference it, and there are harder ways to reference it. In my case, it is the harder way to reference it. And the way we are going to do is with get all actors of class node. Let me show you this one. Get all actors of class. And this one is actually not so a nice node, but it works very nice. Actually, the problem is, if you have a scene with many, many actors and you are calling this one many times, this can cost performance. That's why they say it's not good. I think as long as you don't use it on a tick method, it's fine. Or at one time or two times, because it's still fast, I think. So what does this node do? Let me explain this fast. This actor, it says get all actors of class, means it will jump to your scene, and you can see here the world outliner, and it says here 39 actors, for example, and it will scan all these actors here. It will. And then what you have to do is specify which actor you want. In our case, because we have placed it here in our scene as well, it is called BP Sphere Area, right? It will scan all, and the specified one, which is our BP spawn area, and I call it now here this one, it will take it. So with other words, it will take this one now and say, okay, I get it for you, it here to your coding place, right? Something like that. So the next thing is, this one is still not finished. It is says this one, what you here selected is just search this one, but after you search this one, here is outer actors node, and what you have to do now is you pull out it and say get. This is very important, and what we are using most times, it will create this from an array, because this one is an array, and get a copy. So what it does is this one scans all actors here, and then in an array, and this one which you have selected here will pull out And the zero means the first one which you find here probably. And then you have now access to this BP spawn area which we have placed here. So the question is, why the hell we do all this stuff? The reason is I want this location. For example, now I have this blueprint, what I have placed here. Actually, I can get his location. And how to get his location is, you can now, you have to go from here on, because first you select it, then you have search this one, then you pull it out, and now this one, what you see here, is actually this one, which you selected, not here, here. And that's why we have to go from here. And then you pull out from here and say, okay, now I want your location, for example. And then you can find here many, many settings for this one. And what we are interested in, let me show this one, what we are go. Yes, there is a little bit interesting things. In our case, there is another node. Let's random, we will use this one, random point in boundings box. Let's find this one first. Random point in bounding box. This one is a random node generator, and it says random. Let's read it, because it describes it perfect. Random point. So a random point in a bounding box, which means it creates an area and it will select this area, right? And in our case, it's perfect. We have here an area, yes, and we want that this one should anywhere spawned here in this area, and this node is absolute perfect for us. And it's a math node, so we don't care much. We know it will select anyhow a point randomly in this one. The only thing we have is to connect it to our spawn transform location, because this one is a vector, and this one, the first one, is also a vector. You can see it on the yellow color here. Here is also yellow, careful, so the color is not very important. But normally this is also a vector, but this one is a location vector, and this one is a scale vector, and this one is a transform, a rotation vector, and so on. But let's connect this one and not talk about vectors right now. So the problem here is this thing here, random point in boundings box, say I want a start point. It's called the first one center, or a center point in this case probably. And then I want half size. Is this really the right one? Random point in boundings box, I think, yes. And then it says I want the next extend. I'm not sure if this one is it. So the point is now how I connect this one with this one. So how I get location. And I said before, this one, what we get here, this class has a location, right? So I jump fast to our spawn area. This one has, and I go to this call area, and I can see it has a transform. So it has a location, it has a rotation, and it has a scale. Here, it says I want a location. The question is now how we get it out of here. So you pull out, and you could write, for example, location. And we have a problem when we write location, for example. There are many, many, many things. And this is not working this way, because here is again missing one step. What is this missing step? Let's go back to the spawn area and see. We need first this call spawn area, this collision, which we added at components. So you see, it is on components. We have added this, and then we write the name call spawn area, and this is the thing what we added to this blueprint. The problem is here, when we watch it again, we have only get this blueprint. So which means we have just get the whole, oh, not this one. Where is it? Here. We have got just get the whole blueprint. Let's get rid of this one. It's enough. So we have get the whole blueprint, which means it is here on top till now. But it says, but when we want this one, we have to specify it one more step. And this one is the missing part. So that's why I have to do one more step. And let's do this step. I watch it here. So the first thing is, I get this component actually, and let me show you how I make this. We have here this cold spawn array, and this is a little bit tricky sometimes too. To get out, you right now call, normally you would write this one, right? And then spawn area, and here we have a problem. Here are many references, which means you can do a lot of things. You see all the options, this in details. Let me go here again. When I'm here, all these details, what you see here, are more or less shown here too now. Call spawn area. So, for example, you can create here set collision enabled was in details and ignore actor and so, but how the hell I get now the component? I want just the component which I added first. Or then another solution is you find directly the exactly extent this location and for this one. But this is sometimes hard, or let's say not hard, because you have then here search around. If you don't know, what I do is just, okay, we have again the problem which I had before. No, please not. So the problem is there are normally a default section. And I don't know why it's not popping up here now. Let me go here. Of course, it's not here when I search it. Normally, there is a default section, which means where it shows actually the components. And then you can select it. And here, it's not showing. Let me click this one away. And click this one away and write it again. Call spawn, and now it works even not. No, spawn array. Let's write spawn area. And then let's find nothing. You see, I don't know what I make wrong. Sometimes it's doing so. Anyway, what there is normally a default section, default class section, and let's activate this one. Let's go the easy way now again. Let's write again our call spawn area spawn. What's going on now? Again, call. Okay. And spawn. I don't know. Call box. No. Call spawn area. Yes. I have compiled all. Let me compile this one more time. Okay, one more time. Call spawn. Okay, all this one. I don't know why it was not here. It's again because I don't find anyhow this default section here, which normally it's on the bottom here, and then default class, and then from default class you would get the component. I don't know what I made wrong here. Anyway, just click here one of them, and the thing what I'm searching is normally this one, and just delete the last one. This one you find normally here in default classes. I don't know why it's not popping up, but okay, whatever. And then what we are going to do from here is we are not stopping here. We have to do one more step, and the step is, like I said, we will look the requirements, and the requirement said, okay, I want here in box extent normally, because we need a box extent. And the box extent means, let me show you this one fast too. Box extent is this, what we set here, this size, when we have made this big, right? This is the box extent. And okay, you want the box extent, then we can write box extend, and then you see we have here options, and here in variable shape get box extend, because we want get this information. Now I select all. Here is a shortcut if you want align this line, press Q on my keyboard. Perhaps you have another key, but you can see then all things get aligned. It's a very nice thing to know also. And the next thing is, now I have the box extent, I select this, and now this is just a setting which this node needs. I want the box extent, and he says I want the starting point as well. So what we do is, I watch here again. Okay, then now we careful, we have to distinguish here a little bit. This was the spawn area, but I want the starting point. And when we watch our spawn area, it is not this one. The call spawn area is here, but the starting point is actually the root component, which is in the middle anywhere, because we placed it here. But there is also probably another way to do it, but I just get root, rewrite root, and you see here that this one I expected normally before to. Normally when you go here, there is a variable and then default, and then default scene root, get default, get root component, for example. And then from this one, you get here also location, location, get location, location. Is there something, or here on variable transform, get relative location, and you see we can go here in and adjust it here, and you see it's all not aligned again. I select, I press Q, it's aligned a little bit. All right, I think, and let's put this a little bit down, and we have made here this part. So I compile and save. So this one, it sounds so complicated at start, but believe me, later you make this instantly after you get it. And because you will do this most time it is just get the blueprint, get one of this component, get this location. Most time you get the location, and then you plug it in, and that's it. Also, I try to explain it more than it is. It's easy. So on top, I have here something more, and I will show you this before. Let's start and demonstrate me if this is working, because there is one more thing why I have this strange looking thing here. So when I start this one, I play. Okay, we should not start from here, but you can see it was spawning already in a random position. Okay, that works. That's cool. Let's start this one more time. Oh, this time it spawned here. That's cool. So in general, this one is already working. It's spawning our teleport. Of course, later it will be not visible, because our definition is find this teleport as fast as possible. And here is the case, not here, but almost the case where I say, when it spawns in this one, I want still be able to walk in, and then I walk on top of it. Anyway, this works. So why the hell I have made this strange looking code here, which we will add here too. So the point is, let me start this one more time. I start this, I run. Our game definition is find as fast as possible the teleport before the zombies, monsters, or the time runs out. And I go in. Perfect. It worked. I found the teleport. I switched the map. All fine. But you can see this one is again here. You can see it, right? This teleport thing. And when I run in, it loads again the map. And when I press now stop, I get errors. And many, 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 many errors. So what happens here is, let me show you. This errors, it says access non trying to read property and so on. And then it shows where the file is, where it can't read. The reason is, well, let me show this one. This is also to understanding interesting. So you go in, you find it, but here, this setting up of this this spawning code, right? We spawned this teleport has not all requirements. For example, show this here in our game. When I spawned this one, it will be spawned. Oops, here it will be spawned here, here, and so on. But let me go here too. But we have a game mode, and the game mode. I said this game mode of our third game, third map is the same like here, and it will start at start this node again, which means it will start event begin play. It will then try to find all actors, and I explained to you this a little bit, and it will try to find this BP spawn area, and then try. If it's, and then it will try to do this one, right? But the problem here is on our new map, let me start this one too. We have here a spawn area. We have placed it here, but on our new map, we have not a spawn area. And that's why this errors occur. Here, the game mode starts again, our begin play, and then it tries to find this strange defined spawn area, but it has not here. That's why it says, I try to find your spawn area in this new map, but I couldn't find it. So you can see at least here, here it says game mode. In game mode is trying to find BP open new level and so on. And then in the end effect, it says, I try to find it, but I can't read it and so on. Okay, that said, how we solve it? There are many different ways to solve this. I choose again a very, the first one, which I found actually, it's probably not the best, but whatever, it works. So what I did is just, let's do this, to make a check. First of all, I want to check, and in general, you make a check with a branch. So you press, you can right click and find this net breach branch and find this node branch. And it says flow control. This one is it. But in general, you can think about it is a condition check. And which means it, this one goes here in. If your check is okay, you go with true, which means is okay. If your check is false, also which means it's not okay, you go with false. So, and what we want to check here is just, for example, a bad way would be check if there is a spawning, yes, a spawning area. We could check for a spawning area, but this one is again a lot of work, because then you have to find again a reference, something like that, and so, and I don't want that. So instead of that one, I choose another way. I said get current level name. This one is all interesting. Well, and this one is, this node is just getting the current level name, which means which level map name is open. Let's go to our maps. Here, our third person map will be open, but on the next map, when I teleport, the map name will be map level 3. So, in third person map, when it's open, I say, I want that you execute this code, which we wrote there. And why I say that, because I know on this map, you have a spawning area, right? This we have. We have set the spawning area on this map. On the next map, we have not set it. So I want only that you execute it on the third person map. And if this is true, I want that you make it. But here, one more thing. Where is the specification of this, of the third person map? We have to say which map, right? And how you can say this, here is the way you pull out this one, and then you write a equal, but in programming a double equal is check, and we want check equal to string, and we have here equal exactly. This would be even with three equal signs. In our case, this one is enough, the normal equal signs. And when what we want to do is this node gets the level name, okay? It checks which on which level it is. So let me explain it from start. So for example, when we have here the third person game mode, and you are on the third person map, then this one triggers from start and it gets this name. Okay, that's so far okay. And now I want just check it if you are on this third person map, and best way is to write it nice and correct is you go to your maps folder, select this F2, it will be selected, don't rename it. F2 means rename, but we are not renaming, we want just select it. Control C for copy. I copied now this name. I go back and I put it here, and Control V to paste. Now if you are, and then I connect this one with this condition, and which what it says now here is check in which map you are. If your map is exactly the map which I set here, it's the third person map, then this is the checker. Is this true? This node checks if this one is true. If yes, true means check okay, go on, check failed, do nothing. So, and that is our full code actually. So we compile, we save. So this one is just the check, and let's test this, right? How we can test it? Let's test it first. If we get this, still this errors, I walk in, the teleport is not here, and let's see if I stop. I have no errors. Perfect. So that was the first check. Then let's do one more check, which is we go here to the where's the main menu, because we start normally from here. This is the point where the game starts, right? And what we are going to do here is, let's see, we just start. Okay, our game starts. I press start. I try to find the teleport as fast as possible. I found it, and yes, perfect. So we have done the teleport, we've opened our own map, and in the next video let's do something with designing. We have coding, we did the coding, that was cool, but in the next video and so on, I want to do a little bit design, and what we are going to design is this map here. We learn a little bit level design or something like that, and you can train of course this coding too till there. Okay, bye so far, and good luck.